Track 7, Piazza Venezia. A trip to Rome shouldn't end without having seen the centre of it all, the Piazza Venezia, or Venice Square, located at the geographical centre of the city. Almost any bus will pass through this piazza, and you have to expect heavy traffic. So, if you're looking for a place to relax, this is not going to be it. But still, the Venice Square is definitely worth a detour. The Piazza Venezia is named after Palazzo Venezia. This Venice Palace is one of the first and nicest Renaissance buildings in Rome. It used to be the seat of the government for the Republic of Venice, but it was built before diplomats from Venice moved in. Pope Paul II had it built during the 15th century. For its construction, lots of stones were taken from the Colosseum. The building quickly became a papal residence. Before St. Peter's Basilica was built, the popes would make speeches to the crowds from the balcony. In 1560, Pope Pius IV handed the palace over to the then Republic of Venice to use it as their embassy. In 1916, the Italian government acquired it. In 1929, Palazzo Venezia came to be known as the Forum of Italy, making it the true centre of the city. During these years, the palace was the headquarters of the Italian dictator Benito Mussolini. Take a look at the balcony of the palace and imagine El Duce addressing the people of Italy. It was on that very balcony that he declared war against Britain and France, siding with Hitler. Today, the palace houses a museum with armory, sculpture, and historic paintings from the 13th to 18th centuries. In the southern part of the Piazza Venezia stands the monument of Vittorio Emmanuel II, the first king of the United Italy. Many Romans make fun of this huge building by calling it the typewriter or the wedding cake because of its white marble. But in spite of those nicknames, the monument symbolizes the unification of Italy. It is also known as Vittoriano, after the name of the King Vittorio Emmanuel II, to whom the building is dedicated. To get a better understanding of the history of Italy, visit the museum inside the building. In 1921, an unknown soldier was buried in the terrace at the end of the first flight of stairs, the so-called Altar of the Nation. It then became a symbol to commemorate all the Italian soldiers who have died during the different wars. But if you're not up to learning too much history, the terraces of the monument offer a breathtaking view of Rome. Do sit down and enjoy it. You are in the centre of the ancient world, and in the centre of modern Rome.